morning, 4 a.m. John and I are heading up back to South Dakota, Webster area. Gonna fish with a couple of my high school buddies. They've been with us before. You've seen them in some of our other videos. But hopefully got a good perch bite again. Try to chase some walleyes. We're staying in a sleeper shack one night. Two nights in a sleeper shack. Going through settler guide services. Tyler, great guy. Putting us on some fish, so it should be great. Staying in the sleeper shack throughout the night, and then during the day we're obviously going to chase a good perch bite. But several different lakes up there have a good bite going, so hopefully we can get you some good footage, and enjoy this video.
That's it.
He finally got his noodle wet. Eight-hour drive, 4 hours in the shack. He finally got her done.
Custom Brad DeWall Designs.
Shotgun time, baby. Talk to me. Nice. Hey, all right. Hey, is that a walleye from the walleye family?
The walleye species.
Is that a walleye? Because it's a walleye family.
God, I'm all
Ryan, you got one on you.
Yeah, there was two of them down there.
Little one for the camera. That's a shotgun.
Yeah, this is a perch of the perch families.
There's a little better one.
I'm putting that in the bucket.
I don't care. Got him. Oh, he's stunned. They're still down there.
I mean, that's the thing. They just come in and it is just nothing but fire. There's 4 foot of just solid red fish on the bottom. I mean, you can't even get your bait down there, and it's just impressive. There we go, baby.
That's a dink.
Putting the knife to it.
Still there. They're still there.
Just fire. Action and fire. I've got a little tungsten jig on with a silky, red and white silky. It's kind of nice because you just keep it going.
Damn.
And it's just quick. It's nice. This is a better fish, maybe. Yeah, big South Dakota jumbo. Big South Dakota jumbo.
Lost my bait, John.
That's why you put a silky on. Yeah, that's why you put a silky on, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, this is as good as it gets. South Dakota, yellow gold, coming, just flying out of the ice.
Still
nothing
there?
Better. Yeah, they're still there.
Can't get these things on. Too excited.
Right on them. Just as fast as you can go down, right back up. I mean, this school will stick around by far and away longer than any school has stayed around. That's why we haven't been able to get very good footage, but this is solid. I mean, this is exactly why you come to South Dakota to catch
this
fish.
This is awesome. I'm 10 feet from the bottom and they're starting to come up off the bottom, just racing up to it.
There we go.
I wonder if I lost all my spikes. I can't get them to go. Can you keep that one?
No. I mean, you gotta give a few back to the lake, you know? I mean, you can't just Can't just keep everything, you know? Trying to be conservationist here. I mean, they're still there. They're just loaded. Just can't even get the jig down to the bottom. Ah. Trying to rip his lip off there. There we go.
We are on them.
No shit.
Yeah, we probably just put like 6 or 7 more in the bucket. And they're just loaded up. They're staying underneath us. Yeah, I don't know if you want to move closer this way. I know you probably just got set up, but.
Yeah, we did. Yeah, we might move that way here a bit.
Yeah, okay, sounds good.
Okay.
Okay, I need to reload.
Missed him. Sometimes these little tungsten jigs that you have, they're just a little bit too small and pull them out of their mouth. They're still just stacked in there. There we go. He committed. He committed to the cause.
Fish follow me down.
Yeah, they're just crazy. Did you put a silky on? You just waxed.
I'm too lazy.
Spice.
They're too busy.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, just the experience of doing this right here is something a lot of people, I don't think, get to experience. Bottom 2 foot, 3 foot, just nothing but red marks. That sounds a little better, maybe.
Yeah, this one's a little nicer. The crazy part is we've got two other guys that are with us, Max and Ryan. They're probably 30 yards away from us, and they aren't marking any fish, nothing. It's just the schools kind of travel, and they're right with us here and not leaving.
Which you couldn't ask for anything better. I mean, obviously, I wish
that's
our...
a nice one. Choked it.
Oh, boy, he was aggressive. They're fighting over it, you know? It's awesome when you can see multiple fish come up to your jig, because you know they're going to commit to it. Oh, I keep
John.
Sometimes the smaller ones are the harder ones to catch. True angler fish, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, this is fire. Just nothing but fire. This is why you come out here.
Keep in mind, it's like 1 o'clock in the afternoon.
And it's like negative 14 degrees. It's just insanely cold out. Thank you. my gosh. That, are they still there? I can't tell. They finally went away? No, I think they're still there.
Keep them there.
Yeah.
That's the thing. You got to try to figure out, you know, obviously it works well because we got two people every other, you know, and he's keeping them there. If he catches one, I'm on my way down, try to keep them there. That's the catch here, is you just got to figure out a way to keep them here, and they'll stay around.
Without a doubt, one of the funnest experiences you can have ice fishing, it is on a perch bite like this. I mean, it's just...
This is true A-roll outdoors. This is A-roll experience.
It is. It really is. Yeah, they're still there. I got one.
Gotta get some grubs on. See, here's the difference. John can just stay down there and keep the fish there because he's fishing with that silky. I've got little bugs on that, you know what, if I catch two or three fish, they kind of pinch them off when you get the hook out, and so I got to rebait every now and again.
Well, I tell you what, seems like the school's finally moved on past. I mean, I don't know how many we picked up right there, but...
I don't know. We probably threw 10 in the bucket in, yeah. What, 5 to 8 minutes?
Yeah. This is not good. Bummer. School of fish down there. Mitch's fish got us a little tangled up.
Put your other rod down. Get down there. Why didn't he eat? Why were they so finicky for me and they fucking hammered you? Nice fish. Thank you.
stacked in down there again. What, 10 minutes went by from our last little flurry?
Yeah, probably 10, 15 minutes. Having to work for them a little bit harder today, or this afternoon, than we did when our big flurry came through. Just kind of a little lethargic, I think.
I mean, there's quite the, pressure's rising, right? High pressure system.
Yeah.
It was low when we got here. We fought, 40 mile an hour winds the whole ride up here. It was tough to get the truck to get up to 65, 70 mile an hour.
We still got them down there.
Here we are. Woo! Only people out here. The old mud dog's ready to roll, baby. Final product. Cold front coming through, but still got after it a little bit. There'll be more tomorrow.
Time for a milking. Pro tip, double wrap.
Two of these?
You know, it was a hell of a day fishing.
An old chief over there.
An old chief over here just decided he wanted to take a sleep.
Boil some water
and dip his hand in it. Hopefully he doesn't wet the bed.